I gave up at one stage. I thought, okay, I don't deserve these exams, these qualifications. I would get all sorts of things. I was achieving things, you know, I was a bit of an achiever. And that made me feel good about myself, which I hated. And I stopped my education. Joan came to my side. She said, I understand you. What's all this? You've stopped your thing. I said, Joan, I don't deserve this, for Christ's sake. I said, well, who am I trying to kid? I'm finished. No, you're not finished, she said. You have choices. People outside think you don't have choices in prison, but you do. You can get out of bed or don't get out of bed. You go to the workshop, don't go to the workshop. Educate yourself, don't educate yourself. Read books, don't read books. She said, you owe it to your victims to do the best you can with the life you have left. Then she closed the cell door. There were prison officers there, closed the door, and I was locked in my cell. And it took me a few days to get that into my head, to come to terms with what she said to me. Anyway, I cracked on. I thought, I've got to do the best I can. I'm going to live. I've been sentenced to life. I'm going to try and live. And I did, I continued on. I became known as the guy that could write a good letter. Being good at English, prison's such a small world. Everybody knows everybody's business. And I became known as the guy that could write a good letter. And I liked that. At last, I had a place in my community. At last, I had a role. I belonged somewhere. I had something to offer other people in my circle. I could write a good letter. And I was busy sometimes writing a lot of letters, I tell you. I wrote all sorts of letters to the probation service, letters to the parole boards, complaints to the governor. I love doing those. I got a little vicarious pleasure from writing complaints to the governor. And I had a role. I started writing groups. I got involved in prison magazines. 14 years in, I met a yoga teacher. Wow. That was amazing. His name was Andrew James. He came to my little prison in Nottingham. First of all, at the prison chapel. I hadn't realized just how stressful prison was, telling me Andrew. Because I had a yoga session, he taught me that what was the thing, the rag doll, what was the first thing? Oh, wow. The rag doll, you stand in what's called the mountain position, sort of like this. And then you relax and you bend forward on your back. Like everything, oh God, the tension that was on my shoulders and my back. The relief I felt after that, my goodness. It wasn't just me, there's a group of us in this group. And I started with a yoga class. And that brought some peace into my life, into my cell. So I was the guy that could write a good letter. I was into all this writing stuff. I was surviving on the wings and landings. I was quite a robust character. I had a robust life before prison. So I was a bit of a survivor. I wasn't a goody-goody, but I wasn't a baddie-baddie. I sort of walked that middle line. And I found a way to live in it.